people thought I was kind of crazy, but I always had my mind on trying to make it to the NBA.
You dream about those games. You talk about it, but to actually live it.
And you think you're on top of the world, and the next day, you know, you could be on the bottom.
Watch the stories unfold as Hall of Fame, All-Star, World Champion, former professional athletes share their personal stories of struggle and success.
You may see her in an exhibition game and my legs start shaking. I had no idea that it would go that far.
If a pitcher hit one of our guys, Mickey couldn't wait to get out there and hit their guy. It was just a different era. Oh, he couldn't wait.
The show ranges from the athletes' first accomplishments to their successes on the world's biggest stage and reveals some surprising stories along the way.
I was fortunate to grow up with Wayne Gretzky, who was maybe one of the greatest hockey players next to Gordie Howe.
Back then, no girl was playing, so it was only boys. So they decided to dress me before I got to the rink to make sure nobody knew I was a girl.
I grew up with guys that we just pushed each other. And so when I got onto the ice, it was like I was just with guys who wanted to succeed together. And then when I went to the NHL, well, that's a whole different world of trauma.
If you can't take the ribbing and the kidding you played, then you know what it's like. We ran guys out of pro ball.
I ended up with the Clippers.
And I'm reading in the paper about myself in the San Francisco Times, and I'm sitting there going like, I must be pretty good.
But, you know, you can play for all the money in the world, but if you don't have that championship ring, you don't have anything to brag about.
Each athlete discusses their transition from the pinnacle of their pro sports career back into normal everyday life.
I enjoyed it for about 2 weeks.
Well, that was the great thing about Sparky is that, you know, he'd always remind you, you know, that someday it's going to end.
All of a sudden, knowing that you're done, it hits you that, you know, what am I going to do? Mm-hmm. What am I good at?
Didn't feel like getting up, going anywhere, doing anything.
Yeah.
No calls. Didn't want to talk to anybody.
Athletes take up to a 90% pay cut when they're done playing. Many of them struggle financially and bankruptcy and everything. What was the biggest challenge for you coming out of pro sports?
Stop spending money. You know, it was tough. That was the toughest part for me because for years, you're able to go and buy what you want. Go to any car dealership, pick out any car you want.
The biggest adjustment, I think, for me leaving the NBA was not being able to find that level of competition to play against. It just doesn't exist. Once you play at that level, everything else is a couple of rungs down.
After being a basketball player, you know, you got to take a regular job. You got to go out and you got to do, you know, it's a whole different lifestyle.
It's like either you get with it or you sit here and you starve.
Hosted by best-selling author, sports counselor, and former pro athlete Kurt David, From Glory Days features some of the biggest names in Detroit sports. You won't find another show like From Glory Days capturing these transitions as told directly by the athletes themselves.